Hi and welcome. In this video, I will talk about the precision versus recall curve and also the average precision, or also called AP. That's an alternative to the AUC performance metric that we talked about in a previous video. So basically, I will explain what's precision, what's recall, what's the curve precision versus recall, what you use that for, why the precision versus recall has the shape that it has. And for the average precision performance metrics that derive from the precision versus recall curve, I will explain the math behind it and how it's harder to trick when comparing to the AUC. So it's a better alternative to the AUC. My name is Felipe, this is the Data Science Bits channel. Please subscribe and hit the bell button to receive notifications with every video that I post. And if you really enjoy this video, please hit the like button. For this video, I think it's really important for you to watch the previous video that I made on the ROC curve and AUC. There are many interesting concepts there, and it's the foundation for this video. I will provide a card here on the top. Also, you will find a card on the end of this video, and also a link in the description of the video. So let's now look into the definitions of recall and precision. Recall is something that we already discussed in the previous video. It's called also true positive rate, or TPR, recall, or sensitivity. The TPR, or recall, as we already discussed, is what the model recalls from what it should be, from the positive class, okay? So it's the amount of the true positives over the amount of actual positives. And the actual positives are TP plus FN, okay? The true positives plus the false negatives. The false negatives, you know that they are actually positives. What's precision? Precision is the true positives over the true positives, so very similar to the recall, but now we have here false positives. So what this is telling us? This is telling us the amount of positives that we got right from what we are predicting as positives. So the true positives over what we are predicting as positives, because it's the true positives plus what we are telling that's positive, but it's not really positives, the false positives. So keep this in mind. Recall is what the model is recalling from the truth. Precision is what the model is getting right from what it's saying is positive. Now that we understood what's precision and what's recall, let's talk about the precision versus recall curve. Let's go to the website where I'm making available all the plots that I show in the videos. So you can access this on this address here. I'm providing the link in the description of the video also. So you have all the information here from previous videos. Okay? And this video is about precision and recall, precision versus recall. There's two sections here. So, precision and recall from balanced distributions. So, the threshold is moving forward, as expected. I'm making it faster now. And you see that there's a trade-off between precision and recall. As the precision goes up, the recall goes down. This is the usual behavior that we'll find. And at some point, these curves will cross, okay? The best way to find the threshold, the optimal threshold that you want, where this yellow or orange vertical line will sit and will best split the classes, is in the crossing between the precision versus recall. So, because there is a trade-off, you choose the optimal as the crossing. So, the position where they cross is really easy to find. So, it's around here. Okay? So let's read 0.46. And it's in this position because these distributions here are very close to balanced distributions. Let's go back and let me show unbalanced distributions. This is the case where one distribution has many more examples than the other one. So you see here, the purple curve has many more examples, okay? In this case, you see that the threshold is sitting somewhere far from 0.5. Okay, let's hit play here to make it faster. And in this case, it's easier to see the discretization of the curves and how they are. So it's somewhere here near 0.6. So it's much farther from 0.5, okay? Because it's unbalanced. And you can see here the discretization of the curves in relation to the histograms. And you'll see that the recall, that's the green curve, looks like a stepwise, but the precision curve looks like a sawtooth. So you can see here the spikes. And this will reflect into the precision versus recall curve in the end. So this was the precision and the recall versus the threshold choice. So now let us look into the precision versus recall curve. The precision versus recall curve, as I already said, has a sawtooth shape. So let's understand why is this. I'm showing here the curve already with the spikes here, and I'm showing explicitly the formulas for precision and recall. As we move the threshold from left to right, the curve goes from right to left in this direction that I'm showing in the arrow. So let's see how the recall and the precision change from one point to the other as we change the threshold position. So if you change just a bit the threshold, you may lose one true positive. So this is reflected in the numerator here. But when you lose one true positive, you gain one false negative. So this is reflected in the denominator. So the denominator does not change. So what happens with the recall is that it decreases. So we already know now that goes from right to left. Makes sense. So what happens now to the precision? Something special here happened, that the precision also includes TP, the true positives in the definition. So when you change recall, you must change precision too. They are interlaced. So as had happened in the recall, the numerator is subtracted by 1. The denominator is subtracted by 1 here. It makes sense. And what happens is that false positives in the denominator is also subtracted by 1. It will make sense if you look into the histograms, you'll see that when you lose one true positive, if the curves, if the histograms are intersecting, you always lose one false positive. But looking into this formula is really difficult to understand if the precision is decreasing or increasing. So we are saying that this fraction, this precision, is greater than this other one. If you work out the math, you end up with this expression, and if you cancel out terms here, in the end you will see that you must have TP, true positives, less than false positives. This is the case that the arrow is going downwards, so precision is decreasing. So there is another case where the precision actually increases. So it's in the opposite direction. And here is exactly the same formulas, but we are in another limit. So doing the same math, just replacing greater by lesser, we end up by true positives greater than false positives. What will happen is that in one side of the curve, you have spikes like this, and in the other end of the curve, you have steps, let's say, that look like this. So let's go back to the website. Precision versus recall from balanced distributions first. Let's stop somewhere and I will zoom in, okay? So let's look into this limit here where the recall is not so large, okay? Let's look here. Well, this really looks like what I said. Look here, this behavior. This is not perfectly vertical because it depends on the size of the discretization, the bean size that you chose, okay? And if you look into the other limit of the curve for great recall, you see that this looks much more like the inclined steps that I was talking about. And there is another element in this plot here that I want to highlight, that's the AP. It's called the average precision. It's related to the area of this curve here, but people don't usually call it area under the curve. just to not make confusion with the AUC in the ROC curve. And the reason for it being called average precision is really mysterious for me. It's like making an average of the precision where the weights that you are using in your average are actually differences in recall with each step. And this is basically an area. I will explain later to you. So you see here that AP is really high. It's close to 1, 0.94. It goes from 0 to 1, okay? Now let's look into the unbalanced distribution. So again, you have one distribution that has a lot of counts, another distribution that has much lesser counts. In this case here, it's much more obvious. First the steps, and then the sawtooth behavior, okay? It's much more evident. And you see that the AP here decreased, and now it's close to 0.7. So it's 0.731. Now let's look into the AP, the average precision that, as I said, is related to the area under the curve of the precision versus recall. So again, in the precision versus recall space, you have those spikes, and you could define areas. So in this element of the average precision is the area of this rectangle here. So you must be really careful here. Although this is an area, it must be defined as rectangles. This is the definition of the average precision, okay? If you want to go forward and compute the area under this curve, you may be employing different numerical methods that actually could take into account the inclination here. So for example, the trapezoidal rule would take into account this, but we will get different number than by using the rectangles. So in this case here, where the spikes are, as I'm displaying with the arrow going backwards from right to left, it's obvious that we are overestimating the area when you are computing the average precision. But in another region of the curve, you are going to be subestimating the area because the inclination of the arrow will go upwards. To finalize, let's look into the average precision math for each element of average precision to understand what it really means to compute this quantity. This is just the area of that rectangle, so it's an element of average precision. To get the overall average precision, you sum up this over all the steps in your discretization. If you develop this formula, you'll get this. Okay, so in the numerator you got 1 because the true positives, they cancel out. Developing the formula further, I rearrange it so I have these ratios here in the denominator, and I factor out 1 over true positives, okay? And I will continue rearranging. This is the final form of that formula. So you see that when you increase false negatives over true positives that are represented in orange here, I can always decrease the false positives over true negatives. I will show next that these two quantities, these two ratios are actually independent from each other. That's why you can increase one and decrease the other to compensate. In this rearrangement, I had to factor out this ratio here, true negatives over true positives. So whenever you try to compensate the increase of this ratio here with a decrease in this ratio in blue, so you will never be able to really hack the average precision curve as you can do with the ROC curve because of this ratio here, true negatives over true positives. Even if you keep the true positives constant, you'll be always changing the true negatives to compensate the increase of the orange ratio. In the end, what this tells us is that the average precision truly tells us what's the proportion of true negatives and true positives. So let's understand why these ratios are actually independent, the orange and the blue ratio. Because the true positives plus false negatives, they come from the same histogram and they are constrained to the number of actual positives. I'm calling it here NP. So if you isolate this ratio here, you see that it depends on the number of actual positives and the number of true positives. If you do this for the actual negatives, it's true negatives plus false positives, is constrained by the total number of actual negatives. And you see that these two formulas are completely independent from each other, because they come from different histograms that represents the distribution of actual negatives and actual positives. Okay, so that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please hit the like button if you really enjoyed. I'm trying to show my perspective on these topics, and I think it's a fresh perspective because I have never seen this type of analysis anywhere. Okay, so see you in the next video.